Want to know what's better than having an OTT app? Having an OTT app that actually gets downloads. Let's get started. Hey everyone, my name is PJ and I'm the founder of Uscreen, and welcome back to my channel where I share with you how to grow your business with videos. What I'm gonna cover today will help you generate more money from both your apps and your video content. Be sure to watch till the end because all of this is essential to your OTT app success. I don't know about you, but I've got a lot of apps on my phone, but I'm guessing you probably do too. Nowadays, people expect OTT apps as a way to stream their favorite videos when they want, wherever they want. By the looks of it, this isn't going to change anytime soon. By 2022, app usage is going to be a $120 billion industry, and yes, that's a B in billions. At the same time, the average American is going to be watching 70 minutes of OTT videos per day. Here's what that tells us. It tells us that people want to spend more time and money on OTT than ever before. But with so many apps out there, how do you make sure yours is the one getting downloaded? The answer is having a strong marketing strategy. But here's the thing. Proper planning and timing is everything. You need to make sure you're executing the right strategies at the right time. Let me explain what I mean. There are two phases for launching a successful OTT app. First, we have the awareness or the pre-launch phase. In this phase, your job is to build up the excitement and share information about your app. The second phase is the retention or post-launch phase. With this one, you want to focus on reducing churn and keeping the customer coming back for more. Now that you know the difference between the two phases, let's get started on the strategies. In the awareness phase, there's 8 strategies you can use to prepare for a successful app launch. The first is to set a release date. This might sound like a no-brainer, but I can't stress how important it is to plan ahead. Now remember, you or anyone who's building apps, you can't influence the app approval process. So you want to give yourself a comfortable buffer time, usually around 2 weeks projected time, just to be safe. Up next, we have number 2, understand your audience. Here's the thing, a great app that doesn't address your customer pain points won't get you more views. You want your app to provide value, and to do that, you need to first do some research on your potential users. What do they want to see and where do they want to see it? And once you figure out the right audience, you'll need to figure out which app is more useful for them. Number 3 is building a website. This is usually the first thing users do before installing an app. With a great website, you can host their teaser videos, add new content, create an even more trusted brand around you. And as a bonus, having a website greatly improves and speeds up the app approval process in the App Store. Next is content strategy. People want brands they can trust. So this is the perfect opportunity to validate your brand by showing them just how much of an expert you are. Having trailers or sneak peeks of your content is a great way to do so. With so many apps out there, any kind of high quality searchable content can help you build your trust and your brand awareness. Number 5 is outreach strategy. Never underestimate the power of social proof. Influencers these days have a lot of impact when it comes to awareness. An action step for you is to find brands or influencers related to your niche. Something as simple as an app review by an influencer in your industry can lead to more downloads. And here's the thing, don't be afraid to ask. The worst thing they can say is no. Honestly, you might think most people get influencer shoutouts organically, but I can guarantee you that's not how it works. Once an influencer agrees to work with you, you can form a valuable partnership or even sponsorships. Think of it this way, if people see someone they trust and admire using your app, they're more likely to use it themselves. Number 6, social media strategy. If you've got a social media following on platforms like Instagram, Facebook, Twitter, TikTok, now that's the time to use those towards your advantage. If you don't have a social media presence, now's the time to build one. A good social media strategy gives you a direct connection to your users. You can even use platforms to build an excitement around your launch, share info about your app, and get feedback from your followers. Here's another quick tip. Use your audience to research to figure out what social media platforms work best for them. Next up is number 7, App Store optimization research. Trust me, you need to be doing this. An optimized app means higher rankings in the App Store. The higher it ranks, the more people will see it. And the more they see it, the more likely you are to get downloads. Here's some key things you need to be doing to optimize your OTT app for the app stores. First, use strong keywords in the title and the description of your apps. Second, you need to be sure to mention all the cool features that make your app stand out. Third, don't forget to add clear photos so your users know what to expect from your app. And finally, pay attention to where the majority of your users live because this can influence the search language, which ultimately affects how well they can find your app. Here's another tip. If you're having someone build your apps, make sure to do the research before they start building. This stuff needs to literally be built into your app, and it'll be more work to update it later once the app is already published. And even worse, if your app is already published, most changes for the majority of the apps require resubmitting the app for another set of approvals. Long story short, if you don't want delays, do all this stuff ahead of time. And finally, our last pre-launch strategy is paid ads. And as I said before, knowing your target audience is an important first step in planning a solid marketing strategy, especially when figuring out your paid strategy. Targeted ads on social media can increase your brand awareness, but also lead to more downloads once your app is live. If you want to get the word out fast and efficiently, paid ads are a great way to do it. Now that we covered what to do to get app users, let's move on to what you need to do to keep them. At this stage in the game, you want to focus on strategies that show your users why they need to stay on your OTT app. Here are the top 3 ways to do so. 1, create targeted campaigns. As I said before, social media campaigns are a great way to keep users engaged with your brand, as well as drive even more downloads. For example, an Instagram contest can be a pretty fun way to kick things off. Take a look at this one that Domino's Pizza did for a follow and a repost using their hashtag. People had the chance to win $10,000. Now that's a lot of pizza. Giveaways are an awesome way to both engage your audience and grow your following. But don't worry, you can do it without big cash prizes, although it definitely doesn't hurt. Number 2, send notifications. When you got a fresh batch of content uploaded, you want to make sure your users are first to know. With alerts like phone notifications, you can easily reel in your users back in to keep them on their toes. If you're interested in learning more about in-app notifications and other cool features you get with Uscreen, for example, be sure to check out the link below in the description box. And last but not least, number 3, monitor your analytics. In both pre- and post-launch stages, there's a number of key metrics you want to pay attention to. For example, things like your subscriber count, your churn rate, the average watch time on your content, and the devices they're using, and also the countries they're tuning in from. Each of these metrics is absolutely essential for retention and getting more downloads. All right, everyone, we've covered a lot of useful strategies today. To recap, we've covered 8 pre-launch strategies for generating awareness, and they were understanding your audience, build a website, set up content, outreach, and social media strategy, do the App Store optimizations research, and decide on your paid strategy. We also talked about the top 3 post-launch strategies for retaining users. We covered targeted campaigns, sending notifications, and the importance of monitoring your analytics. When used at the right time, each of these strategies can help you increase downloads and successfully grow your video streaming business. Thanks for watching, everyone. If you want to learn more about the app process over at Uscreen, visit uscreen.tv and I'll put a link in the description below. And be sure to hit the like button on this video as well as subscribe to this channel if you already haven't done so. And I'll see you next time to learn more about the business of video streaming. See you next week.